And I will be taking you through today's press conference for TVN Asia's brand new original production, One Night Food Trip International Edition. Can I have a round of applause for the program, ladies and gentlemen? All right, so before I invite the cast here on stage, because I know you're all excited to see Dara, Thunder, Grace, and Sam, please allow me to say a few words about the program. One Night Food Trip International Edition is a spin-off of the popular Korean travel program of the same name, and they have added Asian celebrities into the mix to further hype up the competition. The program took place in Taiwan, Singapore, and Malaysia, and they have now come here to the Philippines, where a foodie battle between Team Dara, Thunder, and Team Grace and Sam just happened. Now, both teams completed a 48-hour eat, play, and compete trip around the beautiful Philippines with the aim of winning the golden passport, and that is the highest honor given to the program cast. One Night Food Trip International Edition will premiere exclusively on TVN Asia on October 10 at 11 o'clock p.m. with the segment shot in the Philippines, set to air on December 5. So let's all watch out for that. Now, audiences can enjoy TVN Asia on Signal Channel 81, Sky Cable Channel 145 and 191, and many more platforms, of course. One Night Food Trip International Edition is presented by TVN Asia with the support of Cebu Pacific, City of Dreams Manila, and Tourism Promotions Board of Philippines. Okay, so I'm sure a lot of you are live tweeting right now. A lot of you are most probably doing Facebook Live, and we'll be uploading your photos and your videos on your social media accounts. Please do not forget our official hashtags. Hashtag One Night Food Trip INTL. Hashtag ONFTINTL. And hashtag TVN Asia. And please don't forget to tag TVN Asia as well in their official accounts. On Facebook, it's at ch.tvnasia, at tvn.asia for Instagram, and at tvn_asia for Twitter. All right, so I hope everybody got that. We'll be watching out for all of your posts and all of your live tweets and all of your Facebook Lives as well. Now, before we invite our superstars here on the stage, I would like to request everybody to please put your cell phones on silent mode. All right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Let's all put our hands together for the cast of our program for today, One Night Food Trip International Edition, starting with Korean TV host and radio DJ, the very beautiful Grace Lee. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is your chance to take photos of Grace. Yes, please stay on the center of the stage. All right. Let's give a chance for all of our media friends to have their photos taken of you, Grace. So if you could please face our media friends on the left side, please. There you go, back to center, please. All right. Very beautiful. Thank you so much, Grace. If you could please join me here. Okay, now let's all welcome Grace's partner in the show, radio and TV personality. A round of applause for Sam YG. Okay, please stand in the center of the stage, Sam. All right. There you go. Now, Sam, can you please face our media friends on your left side? And back to center, please. All right, thank you so much, Sam. May I have Grace join Sam, please, in the center of the stage for your photo. So again, this is Team Grace and Sam. You can do any pose you want. Okay, how about facing the left side, please? Left side, please. All right. Very good. Back to center. Okay, thank you so much, Grace and Sam. Please join me here. Okay, now we're going to invite our next star Korean fashion and beauty icon, Sandara Park, Dara. Yes, please stay on the center of the stage. All right, and let's give our media friends beautiful poses. You may now face your left side, please, Dara. And again, I would just like to remind everybody of our official hashtags. Hashtag One Night Food Trip INTL. Hashtag ONFTINTL. And hashtag TVN Asia. And please don't forget also our official TVN Asia account on Facebook at ch.tvnasia, at tvn.asia for Instagram, and at tvn_asia for Twitter. There you go. Thank you so much, Dara. Now let us all welcome Dara's teammate. You may join us here, Dara, please. All right. So let's invite Dara's teammate. He's also her brother, singer-songwriter Thunder. All right. There you go. Now's your chance to take solo photos of Thunder. Please face also our media friends on the left side of the stage. All right, and back to center, please. Okay, thank you so much. Dara, may I invite you to please join Thunder on the center of the stage so that they can have a photo of your team. Okay, Dara Thunder, please face also our media friends on the left side. Back to center, please. Alright, thank you so much. Now I'd like to ask Sam and Grace to please join them on the center of the stage for a group photo op. Alright, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. Our cast for One Night Food Trip International Edition. Again, I'm reminding all of you to please do not forget our official hashtags. Hashtag One Night Food Trip INTL, hashtag ONFTINTL, and hashtag TVN Asia. Alright, guys, please face the left side of the stage as well. There you go. And please don't forget to tag TVN Asia official accounts on Facebook at ch.tvnasia, on Instagram at tvn.asia, and on Twitter at tvn_asia. Back to center, guys, please. And may I ask everybody to please step forward closer to our media friends, but not too close because you might fall. Okay. All right. So, you guys, you know, they've been waiting for you to come out here on stage. Maybe you could give them a few words of greetings for our media friends. All right, so let's start off with Thunder, please.
Hello. Thank you for coming here. I really thank you all. My name is Thunder. Thank you.
Good evening. Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. I'm Sandara Park, the pambansang tungkong ng Pilipinas. Really nice to meet you tonight. Let's have fun.
Good evening, everybody. Nice to have you all here. Nice to see some of you again. My name is Grace Lee, and thank you for spending your Tuesday night with us.
Good evening. My name is Sam YG. I'm the newest addition to this K-pop group, as you can tell. I'm the most Korean looking. You'll find out why I'm here in the coming weeks. But thank you for being here, and we do hope that you'll enjoy whatever we're going to be talking about and we're going to tell you about the show tonight in a few minutes.
Thank you so much, guys. And I know they're very excited to hear more from you. So we're all going to have a very short chit chat. May I invite everyone to please have a seat. All right, there you go. Okay, so of course everybody wants to find out more about your lives, find out more about what's going on with the show. So first of all, I want to welcome Dara and Thunder here in Manila. So it's our absolute pleasure to have both of you here. And I know that both of you, we all know that both of you spend some time here in the Philippines when you guys were younger. So what can you say? Has the city changed? Has it changed a lot? How do you like it now, you know, from when you were here before? And are you still in touch with some of your friends here? Dara?
In my case, I'm in Manila like every week, every month. So it's like really my second home. And I think a few years ago when I came back to Manila, I was really surprised because ang dami nagbago. Because before, this place used to be empty.
It's true.
But now there's Mall of Asia, City of Dream, ang daming magagandang building. So I was really amazed. And I can tell my Korean friends, oh, you guys should visit Manila right now.
But are you still in touch with some of your friends from Manila?
Of course, I think 8% of my friends are all Filipino.
That's good to know. How about you, Thunder?
When I was young, I only go to school, house, just the two places. And after I grown up, I wanted to come and visit again, so I came maybe two times for a trip. And when I went to my school and the house when I was a child, it looks really small. And so that was really new to me. And right now when I'm with my sister, it's about more than 10 years, so I'm really excited.
Sometimes that's what happens when you broaden your horizons and then you come back, right? But it's like your world gets smaller as your personal world gets bigger.
He's the one who grows taller.
That's true also.
The school is the same. You're the one who grows up.
Yes.
Okay. That's right also. Very logical. Okay, so for Grace and Sam, how was it for you guys to work as a team? I mean, I tried to beat your foreign counterparts.
As a team, well, I've known Sam for mga 8 years. So alam ko naman na makulit talaga siya. So iniintindi ko na lang siya bilang ano older sister. Kasi mas matanda ako sa kanya ng mga few months.
8 years old.
8 years old. A few months lang naman. No, but kidding aside, because we have a rapport already. We used to work for the same radio station back in the day, and we did a lot of things together under the station, so it wasn't so new to me. I kind of missed him. Nakamiss ka eh.
Indian talaga.
So I was really, really happy to find out that he was going to be my partner and that we were going to be spending a lot more time, even if it was just for 3 days. That was something I was really looking forward to.
Aside from the radio show, I mean the radio station, we also actually hosted a noontime
show together.
Show together
before. Uh-oh.
So that was a daily noontime show. So me and Grace have pretty much been working for quite a while, but it has been a long time since we worked together. It feels good to be back in the Philippines, no? Like Sandara said. Oh, nga pala, no? Sorry. I was gonna say, like Sandara, so much has changed, huh? Dati wala pa yung posting yan, ha? Yung nandiyan na, watan nyo, ha? Yung chandelier, dati wala pa yan, ha? No, but it's always exciting to try something new. Like, you know, working with Grace. I knew the chemistry would be there. It wouldn't be a problem. But what excited me more was we were going to do something we've never done before. You know, travel and try out different types of food in the Philippines. Which got me all excited for what was to come. And, you know, taping with Grace and shooting the past few days has been actually a fantastic adventure.
Wow, that's so good to hear. Now for all of you, is this your first time to shoot for variety shows, like One Night Food Trip? So can you tell us a bit more about the shooting. So I know that Dara and Thunder, they went to Palawan and Manila. Well, Grace and Sam, you guys went to Cebu and Davao. That's right. Okay, so Dara, can you tell us more about the shooting experience?
First of all, I want to thank TVN Asia for helping us with this show because I think it's our first time to do a show together. And I was really happy that I can bring my brother to the Philippines again with me and to Palawan. Pero naman muna, I was really worried because this show is about food. It's a food competition and we all have, we both have small appetites. So I know what's gonna happen. So I said, let's just have fun and we'll try our best. And we really had fun. But pero medyo nabusog talaga ako. I gained weight and medyo may problem to digest.
Baka saan yung weight?
Okay, how about you, Thunder? How was the shooting experience for you?
Actually, it was really fun because it was my first time going to Palawan and it was really a nice place. So I really enjoyed the show and the Philippine food that I ate when I was young. And I ate with my sister again, and that was really a happy moment for me.
All right. How about for Grace and for Sam? Grace.
Well, of course, like I said, it was a really different experience, you know, shooting with Grace. We got to visit Cebu and Davao. I've been to Cebu and Davao a few times, but I wanted to explore more of the food spots, definitely in those places. And of course, hopefully promote the Philippines as a country and the tourism. So, you know, it's great to be part of the show. Thank you to TVN for having me and having Grace on the show. And it was quite an adventure, I must say. We got to try things that I've never tried before, food-wise.
Thank you for clearing that.
Yeah, because some people, you know, I know how you think.
Yeah,
I'm not thinking like that. I'm just breathing the air. Okay, you take away, take away.
You know, we had a lot of fun in Davao and Cebu, and lagi ko naman sinasabi, lalo na pag nag-travel ako around the world, you know, you have to come to the Philippines because it is one of the most beautiful countries in the world, and you have to come see it for yourself. Pero pagdating kasi sa pagkain, hindi tayo masyado kilala, no? So this was an opportunity to not just showcase the beauty of our islands, but to also showcase the unique flavors of the Philippines. A lot of the people who will watch the show would be surprised at how diverse and how interesting our food could be. Lalo na nung nasa Davao kami, talagang namin nakain na tuna, durian, paborito niya. palagi nilang na-associate sa ibang mga kapitbahay natin sa Southeast Asia.
That's right.
Oho. So, this was overall a very, I guess, educational, not just for us, but hopefully for everyone who's going to watch this show on TVN Asia.
And it's going to give people who are the audiences another reason to come to the Philippines,
yes.
Right? Because of the food as well. Okay, for our brother and sister, Kanyam, you guys seem pretty close. Were you always this close growing up? Were you always this close, Dara? Were you always very, very close, the two of you?
Actually, it was kind of awkward because our age gap is kind of big. It's like six years. So before he really used to be a baby. So I always carry him, I feed him. So now I cannot believe that he's
bigger than you now.
Yeah. So we're not that close. I mean, we don't go out together or go to vacation together. So this time was really special. But we never fight. He's really a good boy. Yeah.
Wow, I like that. How about you, Thunder? What can you say? Is she really a big sister, especially during the shooting? Or do you take some of the responsibilities as well?
I don't actually remember that we played together when we were young. But I remember we put some water in the balloon and we just throw to each other.
Oh, at each other?
Yeah.
It was so young, nung unang panahon.
Yeah, I just remember that.
different in a manner. Shepherd,
yeah, of course it was me because I was taller before.
Yeah.
Now, would you like to try another Wonder Balloon fight now?
No more.
Okay, and for Grace and Sam, okay, so is this the first time that you guys traveled together?
No, not the first time, but as a tandem, as a team, yes.
Oh, and how was that? How was that experience? I know you already said earlier that it was great. You had a good rapport, right? So you can second guess already what the other's thinking. Parang ganong level na ba yung relationship niyo?
Well, Grace always wanted to travel with me. You know? She always texts me at 2 a.m. Hey, wanna meet up? Wanna go to, you know, Hong Kong, Palawan, Davao?
Wow!
But I always have no load, you know? So I never really replied to Grace. But now there's a reason to travel, no, with Grace and the, what you guys did, the balloon fight? We did it last night. The balloon fight, it was fantastic.
The water balloon fight.
Yeah.
Wow. That's very, very interesting.
Yeah, this
can also be a weapon.
Seriously, we traveled together for a company out there because we both work for Magic 89.9, the radio station. But it was more like a company thing, not really for an adventure or for a show or anything like that. So now we had to mix a bit of work and pleasure. We wanted to keep the show fun and light. We wanted to, you know, enjoy ourselves. We wanted to showcase what the Philippines has to offer. So there are a bunch of things we actually wanted to do. And the great thing with working with Grace is, like I said, we work together, the chemistry is there. So it's just a matter of, you know, finding the spots and actually making the most out of it.
Alam niyo, pag nagtatrabaho kayo with Sam, it doesn't feel like work. Even the most serious work, he makes it fun. There's not a single dull moment. Comedy kasi siya eh. Kahit minsan medyo mahangin. Tumatawa na lang ako para hindi siya mapahiya. Sa crew namin na galing pang Malaysia, di ba? So, tawa-tawa ako. Kundari nakakatawa talaga siya. and eating our way through Davao and Cebu, was hilarious with his jokes, but I found out that I could eat more than him.
Yes,
yun nalaman
that's
ko.
A big discovery.
Hindi talaga pala siya matakaw. Ako pala mas matakaw sa kanya.
Talaga?
Oo, buhay bigay naman sa akin. Sabi niya, hindi ko na kaya, Grace. Sabi niya, ano sabi mo sa akin? Monster.
She's a beast, seriously. Literally, she can eat twice as much as I can. And I'm not even kidding you. You'll probably see it when the show comes out. Wow, but I was really surprised how much Grace Lee can consume. So,
hindi naman halata,
of course, but I mean,
Pero if you have that gift,
okay.
Pero pag
katabi
mo naman si Sandara,
uro
ka sa likod eh, kasi
parang yun. Basically, ang nangyari dito, nakita nyo naman yung summary, sila nag-lose ng 10 pounds, kami nag-gain ng 10 pounds. Yun ang summary, you know?
Okay, so the four of you tried to complete as many missions as possible in 48 hours. Yan. So, paano ginawa niyo? Did you guys come up with a strategy? Sino mauuna? Somebody's going to take a particular role in a particular mission? Is that what you guys did? Let's start with Grace.
Nung unang araw, talaga kain lang kami. Kasi syempre, you don't know eh. You don't know the capacity. Although, when it comes to eating, I'm pretty confident. Because I hear it from my friends all the time. And they always ask me, how can you eat so much? Like, hindi ka ba pinapakain sa bahay? Pag lumalabas ka, kinakain mo lang. So, the first day, we were ordering rice, we were ordering desserts. So, we were just killing it.
Wow.
Pero natuto kami. We learned our lesson. So, on the second day, hindi na kami nag-order ng rice. Kasi nalaman namin, rice fills us up
right
more quickly. So we learned techniques. So on our second day, we would strategize in the van, transferring to the next location, on what to order and how that food will digest faster so we can eat some more.
And it also helped that I'm Mumbai, no? So the negotiation, the barter exchange, no, was very handy. It was my ancestors that came to the Philippines. We used to trade pottery for electric fans and planchas. So I made sure that we actually learned a lot as we went along. How to strategize, what to eat, what not to eat. Like Grace said, rice, slow down the rice. We'd actually think how much, you know, snacks we could gain from our particular dish. If it's not worth it, we'd not even bother, you know, touching it. So yeah, these things you actually learn along the way, and we learned a lot. especially about how much food our bodies can handle in 48 hours.
48 hours, that's right. How about for you, Dara?
Wow, I'm gonna need that. We really need strategy because we know that we can't eat that much. In my case, I cannot finish one burger.
Really?
Yeah, one ramen.
I want to be your friend. I'll finish your food for you.
Grace could finish four. I am not kidding.
Yeah, lahat ng kasama ko, kumata ko sila because I used to order a lot and I taste little by little like buffet style. So the rest, yung mga kasama ko yung kumakain, so kumata ko sila. So nag-usap kami, I think we should share a plate because we have to finish one plate to get one stamp.
Right.
Yeah, so kung hindi namin kaya, sinabi namin, okay, let's just choose one and finish this plate. And then we also negotiate with the director to give us more stamps. So I dance for them. Sumayaw ako.
Talaga?
Yeah, just to get the stamp.
Buti na lang tayo mga
spaghetti, mga ganon. Ocho, mga ganon. But since they're Malaysian, they don't know that it's uso in the Philippines. So tinanong ko yung mga tao sa restaurant, alam niyo ba to? And they said, yes, we know that. So he gave me one stamp.
Wow.
It was really hard.
Buti na lang. What about for you, Thunder?
Actually, we made a strategy, but since our stomach has a limit, I think it's useless. It was useless. Yeah. With or without strategy, is this
one. We also play Potopotopi. So the loser will finish the food.
Yeah, eat more.
Yeah. But aren't you glad you have a very talented sister who will do the ocho ocho just to get the stamp for you?
Yeah, I get a stamp more by making voice imitations.
Wow, are you talented pala siya?
Yeah.
Ang saya naman. So what was the toughest mission for all of you? What was the toughest mission that you experienced during your taping? For you, Thunder.
It was, I think, the hardest part was challenging the Tamilo.
Tamilo, yeah, Tamilo's exotic food.
There was a worm from mangrove tree.
Right, yes.
It looks like oyster, but since I cannot eat the raw ones, I could have challenged it, but it was really hard.
You couldn't put it in your mouth.
Yes.
Were you able to do it?
No.
So the director said, okay, I'll give you 5 stamps if you eat it. But we couldn't do that.
Sorry.
How about for you, Sam? What was the toughest mission for you?
Durian. I'm not sure if you guys have, I mean, you probably tried durian, but when you have like 2 whole durians, everything changes. You start dreaming about durian. You start burping durian. You start sweating durian. It's bad enough I'm Indian. Imagine mo Indian ang may durian pa. Dude naman. Let me translate. It was wild. So, you know, that was for me pretty intense. I don't know how the hell Grace Lee could actually manage eating all that durian. She was downing one durian after another, but I was just at the third, you didn't see I was slowing down, but she was gunning it like durian was going out of style. Parang lahat durian bukas, no? That was, I think, the toughest challenge for me. Because for me, the smell of durian is just too alarming, you know? Alarming, but parang magnanakaw lang, it's too alarming, ha? So, yeah. So that for me, that was the toughest challenge.
How about you, for you, Grace? Obviously, it's not durian.
No. I love durian. I can eat for breakfast, lunch, dinner, and maybe a little more for snack. Midnight snack. Right before I sleep. Just kidding. My biggest challenge was not so much of the eating or the traveling, but because this guy is so funny. You know, sometimes you're the whole time you're eating, di ba? Tapos kung magpapatawa siya, minsan yung punong-puno yung bibig mo, ang dami mong pagkain, tapos magpapatawa siya, and you don't wanna, you know, be unladylike in front of the camera. So yun yung pinakamahirap sa akin that I had to control and I had to keep him in check also. But it's funny because our crew from Malaysia, noong una, parang hindi niya nag-get yung humor niya. Nako, after mga 8 hours, best friend na. Nakapag-appear na dito. Alam niyo yung mga jokes. Merong mga codes na.
Wow.
Na nakukuha na nila. So, yeah, it was fun, but at the same time, his humor could be challenging at times.
Okay, I can understand that. Just for being here for less than 30 minutes already. But what is the fondest moment naman of your trip? Let's start with Sam.
Fondest moment would I think, well, I would describe that the trip as nakapagod pero masaya. Because literally, you know, I flew out on a Saturday morning, went straight to the action, got to Cebu at 3 in the morning. Sunday, we were just slept for a few hours, and we were eating again. What made it memorable was really just, you know, jumping from one food spot to another. Isip mo, papakabusog ka, all out. After 1 hour, kain ka na naman, all out na naman. So parang it was really a test of your you know, capacity. No? It was good, no doubt about it. Masarap yung pagkain, no? But you know, it's also, you know, it was fun managing everything, fun working with the team. I think shout out to the team, to Kimchi and Curry team. It was fun shooting with everyone. They, we were all, you know, by the end of the trip, we were all just hanging out and enjoying each other's company. We became like a little barcada. I think that was, you know, it's more of the experience, and it made it worthwhile.
How about for you, Thunder? What was the fondest, your most favorite moment of the trip?
It was not the funniest, but when she danced the ochocho.
He was covering his eyes.
Yes.
I don't know why.
In the restaurant, when other people are eating their dessert, she was dancing.
And did it for us to win.
Yeah, but it was a little embarrassed, so I wanted to leave that place.
So that's really one moment that you can never forget.
Yes.
It's something that's stuck in your head already. How about for Grace? What was your fondest moment of the trip?
Meeting people from Davao, Davaoenos. Because it's my first time to go to Davao. I frequent Cebu, but Davao was my first time. So I was really excited to meet the locals there, and they did not disappoint. I think my memory of the Davaoenos will be my favorite memory from our 2-day TV schedule.
And for you, Daryl, what was the fondest moment of your trip?
Actually, everything was fun to travel with my brother. But the most memorable thing was at the crocodile farm in Palawan. Yeah, so we went there and we met hundreds of crocodiles. It was my first time to meet them, so I was sweating. Nakakatakot talaga. It was really big, as big as this stage, I think. Yeah. So after saying hi to them and picture taking, and I was touching them, I said, "Okay, nice to meet you."
Touch them?
Yes, like that. And when we came out, this is a shocking part. They were selling crocodile feces. So they said, do you want to try? I said, huh? I just met them and you want me to eat them? So I said, no, we're friends. I'm sorry, I can't.
Okay, so thank you so much for answering all of my questions. I hope it was fun for you to reminisce everything that went on or what happened in your trip. Can I have a round of applause for these 4 superstars, ladies and gentlemen, please, and I'm sure all of you will be having a lot of interesting details to write about. So at this point, I'd like to invite everybody to please move to the front of the stage so that we can take away all of the chairs here so we can have another photo op together, of course, with our TVN Asia and sponsor representatives. All right.